judgment on hauntings.
Oh, I'm Anthony Geary.
I'm Tim Heerdink. This is another episode of Beyond the Fog. Alright, so yeah, we're running a little late on this one. Already after Christmas, but better late than never, huh? Okay, so.
True.
This episode kind of ties in with our next month's season episode where we deal with the house. This is the last Beyond the Vlog episode in the house that we've been in the whole time. Probably still have this couch, but you won't have all this behind us. I know, you'll miss it. Go ahead and cry.
Damn, okay. That damn couch again, guys.
But, so we're going to, the topic of today is attachment, like residential hauntings and how spirits and different things can follow you from place to place. A little bit of history, I mean, like, I've had haunting experiences from when I lived on Pollock and Evansville on the east side to Chandler to the north side of Evansville to here and on, saying it's time to be done moving to Newburgh and I don't want it. So it's kind of like, it's hard to know why something would be following you. Could be like an object, like in the episode that we had, the first episode called Holding On, we had a shotgun which somebody had killed himself with. That could have been an object that had something connected to it. The land itself could have something connected to it. I mean, there is a grave supposedly in the backyard. There's just no telling. I mean, is it me? Is it? It's hard to tell. What do you think?
Well, to me, I mean, I think it all ties in with the land. Like, historic events or tragedies can absorb into the soil and last a lifetime. And, you know, items, too, can pick up fragments of life and capture, like, some memories, good or bad, can be, implanted in objects. And them objects can be picked up by different people in their lifetime and some person could have it for a while at their house, and then they get activity out of nowhere, and then their family, 100 years later, could have that same object and have activity out of nowhere. So, I mean, it just depends on the activity, like, what happened, the tragedy or accident or whatever happened and how it happened.
Yeah, man, I don't know all what could have happened with the house on Pollock, but like the house that we lived at in Chandler had burnt down like the year before we got there, and who knows how long it was there since then. But then the north side, I was in an apartment, who knows how many people die in apartments. I mean, it's just like hotel rooms, a bunch of crazy shit can happen in there. And then this house has been around since 1937, I'm sure I've seen some stuff, so could be just a series of bad experiences with the places, or something specifically could be following me. Other people say, and my family say, they don't have any problems, but I think they could just be trying to convince themselves otherwise. Some people get afraid, and some people might not be able to sense things, who knows, but I sure have seen things, and I don't know if it's been from one spot to the next, or if it's I just happen to find it, or if I can just... I mean, there's dead bodies everywhere, not to be confused with the corn song. But, they are dead. People die all over the place. And so, if you're in a hotel where you might see somebody dead walking up and down the stairs, who knows. I mean, you're probably sleeping in a bed somebody died in if you're in a hotel. People croak anytime, any place.
Hospital,
and whatnot. So, that's what happens. It might not be that something's following you, but maybe you just have that sixth sense like the little kid from that movie.
What a twist.
So, they're following their stalkers, the stalking ghosts. They need to be charged.
Yeah. To me, I think that it can go either way. It can go either... Well, I take that back. Usually 9 out of 10 times it goes bad. Sometimes people can't get away from the attachment and then just attach themselves forever. like a permanent attachment or something. I don't know if it's called marking or something like that, or that's different, but you know, when
it's you get, more like something with like aliens and shit.
Yeah.
That's a whole other topic right there.
But I mean, in a logical meaning, it has the same meaning. Like, you've been marked, so that spirit's going to keep on you. It's not going to give up.
Kind of reminds me of that movie Insidious, where like the kid was the one that's haunted instead of the house. Or
so, I hate to say it, but you could be the one that's haunted.
Hopefully not. Maybe I need to be cleansed.
Or something.
Well, this has been a nice venue for our show, and we can't wait to show you what happens in the year 2015. Sorry for the late episode, but you can get over it. We have a bunch of stuff going on.
So, yeah, we're busy guys.
Busy cats over here. So, the next time we'll be in a fancy house, bigger than this one, on the same couch.
I'm working on getting my PhD and taking over the world.
Hell yeah. Next time you see him, he'll be Dr. Evil wanting $1 million. So, well,
I'm Anthony Geary.
And I'm Tim Heerdink.
And remember, there's always light beyond the dark. Vlog.
On the vlog.
There's always light beyond the
vlog.